Hi everybody, John BTV Digger here for my next video. Thanks for joining me. These videos are going to take place over the last 10 days, last few days of March, through about last Sunday, April the 10th or something like that. Three separate hunts. Really, most of the finds I find are on two hunts. One hunt was kind of a dud and I gave up after a little bit. But come along and join me. I dig some plenty of trash, but also some good old relics, 1800s and early 1900s coins and relics. Hope you enjoy it. So here we are at another place today, public park. Relatively new spot here. I haven't tried this out, but I've been encouraged by some of the targets that I found. The noise right by a busy highway, so I apologize for the noise today. But in the first spot I've dug that sounded something realistic, worth digging. And by the way, the ground's really frozen today, so no more live digs again. Some of the ground is soft enough to dig, and then other ground is really tough. I've got a pair of little like chicken beak protectors so the chickens wouldn't peck each other way back in the old days. Oops. Aluminum. There's an old house site here, so I'm encouraged. Hopefully I can find some more than this, but this was the first target literally 2 minutes in, and this was 2-3 inches under the surface. So I don't think this has been detected really much before, because this would have been an easy target to find. Anyway, on to the next. Nice chicken blinders to start the day. So here we are at the next hole. I'm back in one of my favorite places again. Place with the chicken blinders really didn't work out that well. About 30 of those doggone things there. But anyway, I'm back in just working along the rock wall here, and I've got a really good signal in the hole. And I've dug quite a bit of trash today. But let's see what we got here. Somewhere in here. Bear with me. It. There we go. I'll turn that off here and see what that is. Some kind of round piece of lead, maybe. Nope, not a piece of lead. Not sure what that is. Some sort of medallion. Heavy. Really solid, like maybe brass, or it rang up like a 75. And the AT Pro. I'm gonna have to clean that off and get back and see what that is. Interesting, it's got like a little fob here on the top. So some sort of pendant or medallion. I don't think it's a watch case. It's almost too thin to be that. I'll get back and we'll see what it is. So here we are again at another park today. I always like coming out to these old parks in Burlington. I'll pan up here. Lots of wooded area, plenty of trails. Old park. Been around a long time. Over 100 years at least. I've dug a few pieces of trash. I got an old lead sinker weight. And I've got a good signal in the hole here. Let me see if I can dig it out for you. I looked at it briefly. Right here. Somewhere in there, right here, and I put it back down just briefly. I'm not sure what it is. It looks like it's got a flower pattern on it. I'm not sure if that's a pair of cufflinks or it's not cufflinks. See how it's got three chains in it? Maybe a bracelet or a hair clip. Looks Victorian though. I will clean that up and we'll get back to you to see what it is. A little bit bent up, but that's a good start to the day. I've only been here about 10 minutes. And the hunt would not be complete if it were not for the spoon. If you look at it right here in the sunlight though, even though this is shallow, it's old. It's got some design on it. So I'll have to get a mark on that. I'll keep that and clean it up. It's not silver, maybe silver plated. It's only about 3 inches, right on the side of the trail. If you look, it's got some sort of fancy on there. I'm not sure exactly what that is, but older for sure. All right, on to the next. And here we are at the next hole. Get my pinpointer out here. I looked at it just briefly. Nice old thimble. A little smashed. Can't tell if there's any writing on it or not. Doesn't look like it. Looks plain to me. But heck, that's a nice old find. Excellent. Alright, on to the next. Okay, still working along the old road here. It is a muck fest today, let me tell you what. I've been walking up along the road. This is an old road with a couple of old foundations on it, but the creek has turned into the road. Or the road has turned into the creek, so to speak. And you often see this, the road's so depressed that the creek changes course, and it looks like gravel underneath, but it is really crummy. But I always love checking these old roads. And I've actually got two signals down in the hole, and I got a glimpse of one thing here that looks pretty good, but I can't tell what it is. Let's see what we got here. It looks like can't tell if that's a mercury dime. Nope, look at that. It's a young Queen Vicky dime. Silver. See on the back here. Holy crud, it is toasted. I don't know if I'm gonna be able to get a date off of that. Boy, that's gonna be really tough. But you can just make out. There you go. You can see a young head Queen Victoria. I'm going to say that's before 1890. Young head usually 1860, 1870. But I will clean it up and we will get back to you on that. Now, I've also got another signal. Let me put this one down on my shovel here. And let me turn this back on. It was in the hole with that dime. And so I don't know what it is. It could be junk. I've dug a ton of shotgun shells already today. There it is. It is a coin. There it is. And what is it? Indian, maybe? Yep. It's an Indian. It's hard to make it out. Can you see the back part of the headdress right there? Here, I got some water right here. That is cold water. And man, I'll tell you what, that's a toasted Indian. Holy crud. I'll have to do a little cleaning on that. I can't even tell what's right side up on that. But anyway, very nice. I will get back with you after I clean up and see if I can get a date for you. On to the next. And one of the cardinal rules of metal detecting, other than respecting private property and taking out all trash and filling your holes, is to recheck your hole. And after that Indian head and Queen Vicky dime, there's another coin somewhere, because I just saw it, or heard it. But, let's see where it is. I may have to get back with you here. I know it's here somewhere. There it is. Let's see what we got. I'm just going to wash it off in this mud puddle again. This is the easiest way to see what we got. These are all crusty. If the time period is right, this is another Indian. Oh yeah, another Indian head penny. And it is in the muck and it is severely corroded again. But we may be able to get a date off of it. Based off of that, another 1800s coin. Good deal. We'll be on and get you with the next. Well guys, the hole that keeps on giving. I'm not going anywhere until the detector stops going off. I swung over this big old deep mud hole, got another signal. Thought it was going to be another Indian head, but I pull out this little tiny guy. And at first I got excited because I just thought it may be silver, but it's some sort of token. It said something U.S. Let's see if I can get it in the light here. It says like U.S. goods on it. I'm going to have to clean it up. It's got a number on the back with a hole in the middle. Some kind of tag or token. 2561, something like that. It's old because it was in there with the Indian pennies and the Vicky dime. So let's see if there's any more. I'm going to try the hole here until we stop hearing targets. Back to the next. Okay, I've moved on from the hole. It finally stopped giving with a token and 3 coins. Still walking along the old road here. There's a break in the rock wall, or maybe there was a pen that they let the animals into. Always check around there. There's a lot of barbed wire in here, but I got a 90 signal right here. Let's see what it is. It's somewhere. And I thought I had it in the plug here. Please be an old coin. Ox knob. Man, I find so many of these things. They sound so good. Big ol' ox knob. Period, 1800s. Oh well, we'll move on to the next. And I might as well show you this. Even though you probably know I dig a lot of this, I just don't want to bore you and show it, but I fill my pouches with these in this park. More than you can imagine. I don't show it to y'all because I probably dig 10 for every one good hole I find. Shotgun shells, these are old Winchester cartridges. Not sure what caliper that is. I'm not a gun expert. Find a lot of 22 cartridges out here too. But anyway, you fill your pockets with those. You got to dig that to get the good stuff. On to the next. About done for the day. But we'll take one last stop at one of my favorite honey holes here. This is not one I've shown you before. This solid hole is really off the beaten path. It's got a lot of water in it year round. I'd love to search down in there and see if I can pull out some old relics, but oh well. We'll search around here. I pulled out a ton of stuff from here. 2-cent piece, several Indian heads, some Civil War era relics, mainly 1800 side. It was gone by 1910 or so. Let me give this a poke around for about 15 minutes or so and then we'll start heading home. All right, you talk about disappointment. Check this out. I got a weird signal, repeatable, high tone. I dug it out of the hole. And then I got a medium tone and then popped it out, and then there was still a high tone in there. So I looked at the, searched it out. The medium tone was this, an old lantern part, just the top with a spool on it. I'm able to get a manufacturer's date on that. I'll see if I can clean that up a little bit. And then the high tone was this, and I got really excited. I thought I had a big old silver of half dollar a quarter. Freaking 83. So some old aluminum dairy tag? I don't know. Some of the signals of this hole have always been weird. You dig holes, sometimes they're good targets. Sometimes they'll be great targets. You dig the hole, there's nothing there. You put the hole back, then there's ringing high again. You can't find it. The soil is odd here, but anyway, I don't know. 83 dairy tag token. On to the next. I have about 10 more, 5 or 10 more.
A nice mid-tone target.
Very tiny, so I'm encouraged it's a coin like an Indian or I had it. Right there. Oh, it's a little button. Little, oh, it's got some gold gilt on it. Look at that. Little cuff button. Very tiny, early, single shank, one piece. Mid-1800s or so. Very nice. Hadn't found a button today. Normally I find quite a few of those things. All right, on to the next. All right, folks. Well, that's going to call it a day today. Had a good time today. Spent about an hour and a half out here. Found a nice coin, old coin spill. Lantern part, button, ox knob, a couple other doodads. I'll get back and clean all that stuff up, and we'll show you in the wrap-up here in a little bit. I've got a couple other things I found from earlier hunts that I filmed, and I'll throw it all together in what I found in the last week, 10 days or so, because it's been cold. It's a very mild winter, and then winter decided to return for April. But it's getting warmer in the coming weeks, so we will be out much more, and we'll show you some more videos. But on to the wrap-up. Okay, and here we are back for the roundup after the day's hunt here today. Again, these are going to be finds from the last few hunts over the last 10 days to 2 weeks or so. Most of the finds I found in the last 5 days or so. So let's go through these few real quickly for you. A couple of finds I didn't post in the video. This was a surface find, an old iron buckle. A lot of times you just find these lying on top of the ground or very shallow. I may do some electrolysis on that, I'm not sure. And a couple other ones I didn't post. This one I found was interesting. I did find that in one of the Burlington parks. It's got a red background with a bronco and a rider on top, and it's just a pin. Doesn't have any markings on it. And as you can see there, it's shiny. Not sure what that had gone off of. If anybody knows what that could have gone off, like a bike or a something else, let me know. It doesn't look particularly old, but I would definitely say it's not relatively modern, maybe mid-century or something like that. So I thought that was neat. I kept that. And I don't think I've got anything else that I did not show on the video. Okay, on to the other finds. That first site that I showed you in the video that never really panned out, I had a bunch of these I found, and I finally just gave up. Again, these are chicken beak protectors. They're made out of aluminum, and they ring up really, really good. You think they're to coin. And the very high conductivity, ring up 80 or 90 on the machine. And I just got tired of digging them. They were just so many of them there, and after a while, I started keying in on what the actual number was and how shallow they were, and I just stopped digging, and I gave up on that site. Most of these today, and you'll find them, you can still buy them for farm use and chicken use today, are made out of plastic. These early ones out of aluminum are about 1930s or so, 1940s, so nothing spectacular. I'll probably keep a few of them and toss the rest. Here's my spoon, silver plated, for sure. No maker's mark on back. I did scrub the back of that. You normally will find it right there on the back, but that is completely blank. So I do not know what the maker's mark is. I'm going to guess somewhere about 100 years old or so. I'm going to say early 20th century. Just the style of it and where it was and how old it looks. But again, that's just an educated guess. A lot of these old spoons I'll just toss. This one was semi-decorative. I may keep this one. So that's the old spoon. Here's the thimble I found earlier yesterday. Smashed, no maker's mark on it, just brass, but definitely a keeper. It cleaned up pretty nice. I've been lucky to find several old thimbles over the last few years, so that's a nice find. The ox knob, the frustrating ox knobs that we all find plenty of here in the Northeast that sound just like a great old copper coin. Oh well, I'll throw that into the junk heap. This guy right here, now this is interesting. Remember on the video, I thought it was some sort of medallion. I wasn't sure what it is. Very heavy, cast metal. Not sure what type it is, but what this is a pendulum bob off a Ansonia table clock or mantle clock. So this would have been the bob that would swing there. Why that was lying along an old stone wall in the middle of the woods, who knows? It was on it was by the old road, so maybe somebody was porting stuff out of there on a carriage or something, and the pendulum bob, they hit a bump and it came flying off the clock and landed in the woods. I don't know. It was about 30 yards off the road, so who knows? Your guess is as good as mine. But even though it's not a medallion and it was a slight disappointment, it's got a wonderful design on it. And I just took a little Brillo pad on that and cleaned it up really nice. Again, really heavy. You'd think it almost may be made of lead. But I'll definitely keep that. That's a nice old relic. Again, Ansonia wall clock or mantle clock pendulum bob. All right. Here's my old little flat button. It's got treble gilt on it. Or double gilt, I believe. Again, early to mid-1800s flat button. These one-piecers. Find them quite frequently here in the Northeast. This is my best guess is some sort of Victorian era woman's flower bracelet. It would have had more links on it to go around the wrist, maybe 6 or 7. No maker's mark. I just did a quick little brushing on it, and it's very fragile. I don't want to handle it too much. It already fell apart one time, and I had to clip it back together. But it's a very interesting find. And that's certainly older. My guess would be late 1800s to around the turn of the 20th century. The park in the Burlington area I found this at dates back to that time period, so I guess that would date back to the carriage road era. So I thought that was very cool, and I'll definitely keep that. Okay, now on to the round objects, coin type stuff. My 83 big stinker disappointment dairy tag. I don't know what I'll do with that. That was a heart stopper for about 3 seconds. And then to my other coins and tokens, my Indian heads, unfortunately, I found 3 so far this year, and they are all toasted. I've been on a bad string of not finding the Indian heads in good shape. This one, completely toasted. Can't see anything on it. But it is an Indian. This one I was able to take a little Brillo to. If the Indian heads are in good shape, I'll never do Brillo to them. I'll do much more delicate cleaning. But if it's something that's already toast, I just want to get a date. 1898 on that guy. And you can barely see. That side's that's slightly better. You can see the 1 cent there. Again, goes in the junk Indian pile, Indian head, engine penny, little basket I've got. All right, here's my Queen Victoria dime, probably the best find outside of maybe the wall clock pendulum bob there, which I found. Man, you talk about worn. She is almost all the way gone. You can still see her bust there, and the back is completely toasted. The date would be in the middle, it'd say 10 cents, and I can't make out anything. My guess is, being a young head, it's more like 1880s. I'm going to guess, my best estimate, maybe 1870s, just based off its worn. The fact that this was found in the hole of the 1898 Indian head means it was dropped around the turn of the 20th century. And these guys were made up to about 1901, but it's a younger head style Victoria, so probably prior to 1890. I'm going to guess 1880s. It's been in circulation a very long time. But hey, it's 1800 silver, and I'll take it any day. And then finally, my little token. It's kind of worn, pretty thin, but it basically says good for 50 cents in trade with a little hole in the middle. And the back's just got a number on it. It's harder to read. It says 2561. So who knows where that came from? Very generic. Little trade token, probably from a local store here in the Burlington area. But always love those old tokens. So I'll keep that for sure. All right. Well, that is a wrap for today. And hopefully you enjoyed the video of me finding some of the stuff here in our local parks. And I'll be back soon with some more videos to post as soon as I find some better stuff. And always remember, the stuff is always out there. You just got to get out there and search for it. Good luck and happy hunting. We'll see you next time.